It's the opening round of the NFL playoffs, and EA Sports continues its coverage of Super Wild Card Weekend. It's the Commanders and the Cards, and it's all up next.
Now, from the Valley of the Sun, EA Sports welcomes you inside State Farm Stadium, just west of downtown Phoenix, Arizona.
Best time of the year. It starts with Super Wild Card Weekend, 3 days, 6 games, and this matchup as good as any of them.
Yeah, and really, it's so funny, Mike. We watch these regular season games all year, and it just seems like there's no way the intensity and the competitive spirit could ever be higher. But there is just something different about playoff football in the NFL. You can feel it in the stadium. You can sense it down on the field in pregame. Both these teams have had this as their number one goal all year. Make it to the playoffs. Everybody has a shot. We're about to kick this thing off and get rolling.
The Washington offense is going to make their way to the field for the first time. They are led by the former Heisman Trophy winner out of LSU, Jaden Daniels.
Going on the road in the playoffs, Mike, it's daunting for any quarterback, let alone a rookie. But if there's one thing this guy has shown all year, it's the fact that not only is he resilient, but nothing appears to ever faze him. Getting your team to the tournament in your first year, it's a massive accomplishment in its own right. I don't think he's done yet. He expects to walk into this stadium in a hostile environment and come away with a win. And there's one thing this season has showed us is don't put anything past this guy.
And they'll whistle him down, but not before it picks up a first down after a gain of 7.
Stephanie! Go!
They'll go play action here with Daniel. In trouble, and he's going to be taken down. To do now as they come up on 2nd and long.
Ready?
Here's Daniel. Now a screen going to be set up for Robinson. And a good job rallying to the football, holding just a gain of a yard, and sets up 3rd down.
19, Tiger, 19, 10, no, no.
From the shotgun, it's Daniel. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete. On 4th down, the Commanders going to send out their veteran, Tress Way, to punt. And on the return for the Cardinals, it's Greg Dortch. And that is good coverage by the punt team as they meet him and bring him down. So out comes the Arizona offense for the first time. And here is Kyler Murray, the number one overall pick in 2019, to lead them.
I remember talking to him earlier this season, Mike, and he emphasized the importance of winning their division. That guarantees you host at least one playoff game. Well, that goal, that's been reached. Now, they have their sights set on something even bigger. But to accomplish that, they're going to have to take advantage of this opportunity right here in front of them. That starts by doing whatever it takes over these next couple hours extend their season one more week.
They'll go again here to Connor. And they'll be set up now. Up past the 40 with that one. Here's 1st and 10. Out of the gun, it's Murray. He'll be taken in by Connor. He's going to be taken down, but there's a late
personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
Might give him 15 more yards. Ooh. 1st down throw for Murray. That's left side, and that's the tight end, McBride. And they are in great shape. He's taken down inside the 10. This opening drive going to form so far.
Yeah.
Now they've got it 1st and goal. They'll run it here, and it's Connor to the 5-yard line.
and goal.
Ooh.
On the ground, here's the one-time Seminole. And he will kick this one across into the end zone. Trey Benson. Touchdown, Arizona. Taking care of business on the ground to get the score. And Greg, the big guys up front, they deserve some praise on that one.
Absolutely, Mike. And it really only takes one guy to distort the defense and win his block. But in this case, give credit to the entire unit. They did their job, and they reward their offense with a touchdown.
So now, Prater, after the touchdown, is out to kick it away. We'll start at the four. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Commanders' offense ready to take over as we check out the playoff race in the NFC.
Go!
Off the play fake, here's Daniel. Now pass deep for McClory. It hangs up a bit too much. It's intercepted. Picked off by Max Melton. Now after the interception, we have an injured player to look at. Medical staff going to take a look, see if he can continue here in this wild card round. Start this drive on the ground, and it's Connor. And that'll be good for about a half dozen. It'll set up second down. So after one, here on Super Wild Card Weekend, the Cardinals have the early edge in this one. Greg and I back here in Glendale after this. They'll come up now for second down and four. Now Murray. And they'll whistle him down, but not before he picks up the first down after a gain of seven. Murray looking to throw. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down. Here's a give up the middle, Connor. And he's bottled up after a gain of a yard. Now after the run, we get a stoppage for an injured player. This would be a big loss, and we'll see if he can continue here in the divisional round. On third down, Murray. He's got his man, complete to Wilson. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player.
Biggest.
On first down, Murray. Now he takes off. Can't beat those legs. 13-yard pickup. A scramble leads to a first down.
Let's go.
They'll run with Connor. He'll work his way ahead for a gain of about four. Here's second and six. They'll go right back to Connor. They get 15 on that game. It's good for a Cardinals first down.
Andy. Sit.
Working from the shotgun, it's Murray. Over the middle, it's Harrison. And he will get into the end zone. Marvin Harrison Jr. Touchdown, Cardinals.
We're seeing this so much all across the NFL, Mike, is the value placed on a receiver being able to turn into a runner after they're able to secure the catch. And sometimes it's easier said than done. You want to survive in this league as a wide receiver, you have to be able to make plays like this after the catch. And great job there by the quarterback being accurate, and great job by the receiver running after he makes the catch.
On the return, Noah Igbinoghene. Now an opening past the 30. And he'll be set up well as he is past the 35-yard line. Here comes the Washington offense down. They get set to take over. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit.
Let's 14 go now.
The score as the offense tries to regroup and get going with first and 10. He'll take this forward for about five.
Good decision by the quarterback. In this situation, all you're looking to do is have a positive play. He decides to pull it, and that's exactly what he's able to do.
Open man, that's Devin Duvernay. And he'll be marked down at the 45-yard line. 2 minutes to go here, till halftime. Back with more NFC playoff action.
On set.
After this. Set to go now on first and 10.
Let's go.
Daniels now going to look to throw. And that one knocked away. It's incomplete.
You know, it's hard to speculate, but if we sit up here and we try to just interpret and assume what's going on in the minds of the players and the minds of the coaches, but they seem to me to be a little bit bad. All these negative plays have really started to pile up in the first half. He's got to settle down, have some more efficiency on these early downs, and get his offense into some sort of rhythm.
To go, and the Commanders are on the board. It's now 14-7. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. To return is Greg Dort. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. Oh, the Bucs offense and their veteran running back James Conner set to take over again.
Oh,
on first down, it's Murray. He'll be hit as he throws, and that one will wind up incomplete. Could not step into the throw that time.
Ace.
It'll bring up second down. That's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Benjamin St. Juice.
You know, Mike, anytime a team can go nickel or dime and come off the field with an interception, I just am constantly reminded the importance of defensive best fit when you're building an NFL roster.
Here we go, think
this is not the old NFL base 3-4, base 4-3. Offenses are going to roll out 2, 3, 4 high-level wide receivers at you in this pass-first modern era. If you can't roll out 5 DBs and all of them hold their own and be trusted to hold up, you are going to struggle defending these pass-first modern offenses. For the most part, he's been very accurate with the ball. He's completing over 60% of his passes, but because they haven't been able to get any big explosive plays, continue to push the ball downfield, hasn't really translated on the scoreboard just yet. And this passing game continues to come up short these last couple plays. That's 2 consecutive incompletions in a row. Now they're staring fourth down right in the face.
York's kick is good. And the Commanders are back within 4 at 14-10.
And I can tell you firsthand, Mike, when you find yourself trailing in a game, you don't feel very good about coming away with field goals. But in this case, it does get them a little bit closer and cut into this pass.
The Cardinals offense is going to take over here in the last minute of this first half. The lead sits at 4. So they'll try to add on to that. This drive begins with 1st and 10. A hit as he throws there. It's going to wind up incomplete. The pressure got to him that time, and it'll set up 2nd down. Working out of the gun, Murray. He's going to air this one out for Jones.
Well, not exactly breaking news here, Mike. They got speed on the perimeter that just not a lot of teams in the NFL have. So even though the ball falls incomplete,
I
think they have to continue to do it. Continue to pressure this defense and make them defend the entire field. Because as they're worried about him running by them, there is a lot of space open.
Again, it's Murray. That's hot downfield by Harrison. And he will go all the way. He is shining in this postseason spotlight. That's his 2nd touchdown of the game. And that is number two. Greg, he is off to some kind of start of this one. Two quarters and two receiving touchdowns.
Mike, this is one of those situations where, as a defensive coordinator, you've got to give your group an answer. Because right now, they don't have it for this guy.
And he is stopped at the 25. The drive will begin there. Just going to run it here up in the middle. It'll be stacked up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play.
Bring it.
So it is halftime here in the NFC wildcard matchup as we send you to Orlando to check in with the coach, Jonathan Coachman. He's got our EA Sports halftime report.
Okay, Mike, thanks very much. This, the second of our two games here on this Super Wildcard Saturday. We'll get it back out to you two in just a minute. But first, time to look ahead to Sunday's action here on the NFC side of the bracket. And this one looks like it should be a dandy, as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Green Bay Packers. In the first half, the Cardinals did what they always do, and that's rely on their quarterback, Kyler Murray. He came on after a slow start to fire two second quarter touchdown passes and give his guys the lead at the intermission. These two teams leaving the tunnel and we'll head out with them. It's time to send it back over to Mike Tirico and Greg Olson. Both these teams running through their final adjustments. It's time for the second half. And for the call, let's get it back out to Mike Tirico and Greg Olson.
Carter on the return. And it'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Cardinals offense and Kyler Murray set to take over once again. And we run you through the highlights here. It has been a very big performance from the quarterback position, instrumental in leading and executing, and now trying to finish strong and take his team to the finish line. A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. First play of the drive, and here's Benson. He'll be stopped after a pickup of about three. Jamin Davis there to make the play. Second and 7. From the shotgun, it's Murray. That's caught by Harrison right side. And he's going to be dropped after a pickup of about 5.
Hey, shift.
He'll try and run here with Benson. And he's going to have a Cardinals first down by a couple of yards as they convert on 3rd and 3.
What?
Murray gives it to Connor. He'll power it, push the pile forward. It's a gain of 2. Second down and 8.
What?
They go play action for Murray. Now he throws back over the middle. It is complete.
You can just see the frustration of the defender. Just see him get off the quarterback. He's like, man, hold that ball for one tick longer, man. I'm there to record the sack. Nice job by the quarterback having that timing and rhythm to get that ball out of his hand. You can imagine, he got close this time. That defender, he's going to keep coming, and don't be surprised if he eventually gets to him.
They'll throw on first down with Murray. That'll be taken in. It's Trey Benson. And they're going to be set up in the red zone. They've got it inside the 15. Throwing again is Murray. And that's going to be incomplete, but a flag down in the backfield. That's the
holding
area we usually
offense.
See holding.
Still first down.
Murray gonna hand this to Benson. And a nice run there. He'll be stopped just shy of a first down. A pickup of 9. They face second down and 7. And he'll go again with Benson. And he'll get this ahead. Gain of about 4. And it leads to 3rd down.
What?
from the gun, it's Murray. He pulls it in around the five. And he's going to be taken down short of the marker. And that is going to set up an interesting fourth down decision.
Omaha.
They'll run the sneak. And he's going to have the Cardinals first down as he pushes forward for a couple on fourth and inches.
Let's go. Omaha.
They'll run with Benson. And he's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of action. They'll try it again from the two. Second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And this time, he's in. Trey Benson. Touchdown, Cardinals. He is shining in this postseason spotlight. That's his second touchdown of the game. Prater, extra point is good. And the Cardinals will open it up even further here in this fourth quarter. So now, Prater, after the touchdown, is out to kick it away. Returning is Igbinoghene. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Commanders' offense ready to come back out for this next possession. Things not looking good. But see if they get the turnaround going here. They'll start this drive with first down. This to the right side, but it's going to wind up incomplete. We'll try again here. Second and 10. Operating from the gun, it's Daniels. That's into the hands of Alameda Zacchaeus. His first catch of the wild card game, and good for a first down.
No!
Here's Daniels. He'll get that to Zacchaeus. And they get this one across midfield to the 47-yard line. They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10.
Ready.
Daniels going to throw again. That's taken in. It's Austin Eckler. He's not going to get too far. Tackled after a gain of just a yard. Here's second and 9. In the air, here's Daniels. He's gonna keep it himself. What a run! He brings it to the red zone,
now,
taken
now,
down
faster, faster.
Inside the 20-yard line. And that time, the pressure too much. He'll go down. So 2 minutes left to play in the second half. We'll come back and finish this one off after this. Again, it's Benson. And he'll take this up, working towards the first down mark. He gets five, but is just a little short of the first down. On third down, they go with Benson. And he's going to have a Cardinals first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert on third and one. They try the right side with Benson. Not much to speak of on that one. Maybe a gain of a yard. It's second down. A run with Benson. And he'll be brought down there. And that'll put a wrap on this one. Time has expired in this fourth quarter. So it's a win for the Cardinals. They are moving on in these playoffs. They win here at home as the number two seed. That means right back here next weekend as they'll host a game in the divisional round. So that'll just about do it for Greg Olson and our entire team. I'm Mike Tirico. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win here in the desert for the Cardinals. As we say, so long from Glendale.